Who will tell me the formula for time period of oscillation of a spring? Formula for time period of oscillation of a spring. One spring. Yes, Jatin.
2 pi under root m by k.
Yes, 2 pi under root m by k. And what is the formula for time period when two masses are connected, two springs are connected to a common mass and masses and the springs are connected in parallel? So when two springs are connected in parallel, how does the formula for time period get modified? Yes, anyone else? Anybody else? Himanshu, yes?
Ma'am, T is equal to 2 pi under root m divided by k1 plus k2.
Yes. So k changes. Effective spring constant k is k1 plus k2 now in that case. Okay. So now we are going to discuss two springs connected in series. Now we are having two springs and they are connected in series now. So let's see what is the time period of oscillation now. Okay. So we have two springs of different spring constants connected in series now. It is having spring constant K1, it's having spring constant K2, and they are connected to a common mass M. Now, as the load is attached, what will happen? We can easily make out that the spring with the high K, jiska K high hai, will get stretched less, or jiska K low hai, jiski flexibility more hai, rigidity high hai, theek hai, wo it will stretch less, right? So accordingly, different extensions will be produced now. And different restoring forces are produced or not, let us see. F1 and F2 are the restoring forces in this case, and extensions are different. So we can write F1 is equal to minus K1 X1 and F2 is equal to minus K2 X2. So here we can't say that the extension is same. The spring that is more flexible will stretch more, and the spring that is less flexible will stretch less. So different extensions X1 and X2 will be produced. Different extensions will be produced, X1, X2, that we have taken into account. Now to find the resultant restoring force, what we will do? Multiply this equation by K2 and this equation by K1 and then add both the equations. Let us see what do we get. So we get K2 F1 plus K1 F2 is equal to minus K1 K2 X1 minus K1 K2 X2. From here, we get minus K1, K2, if we take common, X1 plus X2. Okay. And we can easily make out that if the spring constant is less, extension is more and vice versa. So that this product remains constant. Ab is case mein, series mein kya hoga? Aapka restoring force ka magnitude same hai. Theek hai? For this reason. Is this reason clear? If not, you can raise your hand. If k is less, x will be more, and if k is more, x will be less, so that the product will remain the same. So yahan pe hum f1 f2 ko equal put kar sakte hain, their magnitudes are equal. Yes, Jatin, what do you want to ask? Do you have any doubt regarding this? Jatin, do you have any doubts? Okay. So is this step clear? Ab yahan pe x different hai, but f same. So yahan aake hum f same kar dete. Ya from the beginning also you can do. No problem. Aap f pehle hi same le sakte. Theek hai. So f common k1 plus k2 minus k1 k2 and x1 plus x2 is total extension x. एक स्प्रिंग में एक्सटेंशन एक्स वन हुई, दूसरे में एक्स टू हुई, तो टोटल एक्सटेंशन एक्स वन प्लस एक्स टू हो गई. सो दिस इज एक्स. फ्रॉम हियर वी राइट एफ इज इक्वल टू माइनस के वन के टू ओवर के वन प्लस के टू एक्स. कंपेयरिंग इट टू द स्टैंडर्ड इक्वेशन वी गेट इफेक्टिव स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट के वन के टू ओवर k1 plus k2, which is obtained when we add the reciprocals. When we add the reciprocals of individual spring constants, we get the reciprocal of effective spring constant. So same way we will find the effective spring constant in series as we dealt with resistances in parallel. So जैसे हम parallel में resistances के reciprocals को add करते थे, here we will be adding the reciprocals in series combination of springs. So effective spring constant आपको numericals में calculate करने के लिए भी पूछा जा सकता है. So there we can use this formula that reciprocal of effective spring constant is sum of reciprocals of individual spring constants. So have a look at this. यहाँ तक कोई doubt? So we have found effective spring constant in series combination of springs. Okay, series combination of springs. So let's come back to this equation. F is equal to ma so acceleration is minus k1 k2 k1 plus k2 over m into x. Acceleration is proportional to minus of x. So this indicates that the motion is SHM. एक तो हमने प्रूव कर दिया that the motion is simple harmonic. In the same way, we have proved that the motion of this combination of springs is also SHM. Because acceleration is directly proportional to negative of displacement, and again now we will be finding the time period of its oscillation. So we can do by this method also 2 pi root m by k effective spring constant directly you can put in, or you can also start from the basic formula of SHM. T is equal to 2 pi root x by a. वहाँ से भी कर सकते हो, ऐसे भी कर सकते हो. So put this value of k here 2 pi root m by k1 k2 over k1 plus k2. बस वहां पे effective spring constant आपने substitute कर दिया, ठीक है? We will substitute effective spring constant here. All right, students. Now let's take a special case. Special case. If the spring constants of both the springs were identical, small k ले लेते हैं, the effective spring constant would have been k1 k2 over k1 plus k2. K square over 2k, so that would have been k by 2. So effective spring constant would be have been the half of individual spring constant. ठीक है half of spring constant. एक तो ये हो गया, अगर दोनों के spring constants identical हो तो effective spring constant will be half of individual spring constant, और time period would be ये k by 2 put करते under root 2 times हो जाएगा. So time period would have increased under root 2 times. तो अगर हम spring constants same लेते दोनों springs के, and when we connect the springs in parallel in series, then the time period would have increased by a factor of under root 2. तो वो थोड़ा सा slow हो जाते हैं, ठीक है? सिस्टम थोड़ा सा स्लो होता व्हेन वी वुड हैव कनेक्टेड देम इन series combination. And yesterday we did one derivation of springs in parallel combination. We are yet to discuss the special cases. Uske bhi special cases discuss kar lete. If this derivation is clear to you, should I rub this? If not, raise your hand. Okay, so I'm going to rub and let us discuss two special cases of yesterday's derivation of parallel combination. Okay, so parallel. In parallel, effective spring constant is K1 plus K2 and T is 2 pi root M by K1 plus K2. अब इसमें भी अगर हमारे स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट आइडेंटिकल होते, ठीक है, तो हमारा इफेक्टिव स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट वुड हैव बीन डबल एंड टाइम पीरियड वुड हैव बीन रिड्यूस्ड बाय अ फैक्टर ऑफ अंडर रूट टू. टाइम पीरियड वुड हैव रिड्यूस्ड बाय सम फैक्टर, बाय द सेम फैक्टर ऑफ अंडर रूट टू. दैट मीन्स द सिस्टम वुड हैव बिकम फास्टर. कम टाइम लगता अब. सो वेन वी कनेक्ट टू स्प्रिंग्स इन सीरीज सिस्टम विल बिकम स्लोअर. ओके, एंड वेन वी कनेक्ट टू स्प्रिंग्स इन पैरेलल सिस्टम विल बी फास्टर. ठीक है, तो ये इफेक्ट देख लीजिए. सो इन नटशेल वी कैन से वेन द स्प्रिंग्स आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल द सिस्टम ऑसिलेट्स फास्टर एंड वेन द स्प्रिंग्स आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज द सिस्टम ऑसिलेट्स स्लोअर. One more combination of springs is possible. See, let us discuss that. So this is the fifth case of spring. First case was horizontal spring. Second case was vertical spring. Third case was springs in parallel. Fourth case was springs in series. Now the fifth case of combination of springs. Fifth case of combination of springs. So we have now two springs connected in this manner. We have now two springs connected in this manner and a mass is attached in the center. Mass inke beech mein connected hai. So again we are having two springs of spring constants K1, K2 connected between two rigid boundaries and a mass is connected in the center. How this system will oscillate? हम ये जो mass है, suppose we pull it towards right and then release, so mass will start oscillating. Both the springs will start oscillating. So now we are again going to prove that this motion is SHM. And one thing more, when we suppose pull the mass through x distance towards right, what will happen? Spring K1 will get extended through distance x. And spring K2 will get compressed through the same extension, through the same distance x. Ye point clear hai ki nahi? So we can say that x is same here also. Extension is same in this case also. I am telling you again. Suppose we pull this mass towards right through a small distance x. To jitni compression produce hogi K2 mein, उतनी ही K1 स्प्रिंग में एक्सटेंशन प्रोड्यूस होगी. ये जितना एक्सटेंड होगा ये उतना ही कंप्रेस हो जाएगा. सो एक्स इज सेम हियर आल्सो. ओके, एक्स इज सेम इन दिस केस आल्सो. सो इजंट दिस केस इक्विवेलेंट टू पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स? यस. सो दिस केस इज आल्सो इक्विवेलेंट टू पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्प्रिंग. अब रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स देखो, हमारी डिस्प्लेसमेंट इस साइड पे थी. थिंक ऑफ फर्स्ट स्प्रिंग, तो इसका रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स इस साइड पे होगा और इसकी जो कंप्रेशन थी सेकंड स्प्रिंग की वो भी इस साइड पे थी, तो इसका रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स भी उसी साइड में होगा. अगेन बोथ द रिस्टोरिंग फोर्सेस आर इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, सो नेट रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स विल बी द सम ऑफ टू रिस्टोरिंग फोर्सेस. सो टोटल रिस्टोरिंग फोर्स इन दिस केस इज द सम ऑफ टू रिस्टोरिंग फोर्सेस. इट इज द सम ऑफ टू रिस्टोरिंग फोर्सेस. Okay, so F is equal to minus K1X And F2 is minus K2X. Minus K1 plus K2X. F is equal to MA. So acceleration is minus K1 plus K2 over M into X. Acceleration is proportional to negative of displacement. Again, this indicates SHM. This again indicates SHM. And time period of oscillations, 2 pi root x by a. Put this value of a, k1 plus k2, x over m. 2 pi root x, k1 plus k2, x upon m. X gets cancelled and we get the time period t is equal to 2 pi root m by k1 plus k2. Same formula we are getting as we got for parallel combination of two springs. Okay? So that's why I did it very fast because all the mathematical steps are the same. Just the diagram is different. Okay? So this combination of springs is also equivalent to parallel combination of springs. So same two special cases also you can continue. So dekh lijiye dhyan se, koi doubt hai, so you can ask. So all the five, look at all the five combinations of springs and if any doubt is there, you can ask. Yes, any doubts? To anyone? All right. Next is, okay, pause for 1 minute more. Have a look at all the five cases. If there is any problem, you can tell me. Next topic is energy in SHM. Now we are going to calculate energy in simple harmonic motion. Energy in SHM. Energy in SHM. So total energy when a particle is having simple harmonic motion can be written as sum of kinetic and potential energies, no doubt. How can we write the kinetic energy? The displacement in SHM is given by y is equal to r sin omega t. Right? You know this equation. And differentiating, we got velocity r omega cos omega t. So kinetic energy can be written as half mv square. Square this. R omega cos omega t ka square. It will become half m r square omega square cos square omega t. This is our kinetic energy. We call it equation number 2. Dekhiye pehle. You are already aware of displacement in SHM, velocity in SHM. We have already derived these equations. Then put this value of V here and we get kinetic energy, half mv square. Yahan tak koi doubt? See all the steps. See if all the steps are clear. Now we have to find potential energy. Whenever we find potential energy, we have to see some work force into displacement. Here, since we have taken displacement y, so the change will be dy. In place of dx, we can take dy also, no problem. Now F is equal to ma and acceleration in simple harmonic motion, if you remember, it was minus omega square y. When we did all the mathematics of SHM, we got acceleration minus omega square y. So we will put its positive value, of course, here. So that will be omega square y dy. Omega square y dy ho gaya. So to get the total work stored in the form of potential energy, we need to differentiate this expression. So this work will be kinetic energy. And what will be integral y dy? Y 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1. It will be y square by 2. Okay, it will be y square upon 2. Half m omega square y square. Okay. Or you can put the value of y equal to r sine omega t here. Then it becomes half m r square sine square omega t. This is equation number 3. This is potential energy that we have found. Okay, this is potential energy that we have found. Is that clear? So see how we calculated kinetic energy and how we calculated potential energy in SI. To calculate the potential energy, first we had to calculate the amount of work done. So we found the work done that is stored in the form of potential energy. So we got half m omega square y square, and we have substituted y equal to r sine omega t. This becomes half m r square sine square omega t. So there is a similarity between the expressions of kinetic energy and potential energy, you can see. Up till here, any doubt you can ask. Yes. If any doubt is there, students, you can ask here. How we calculated kinetic and potential energy, is that clear to you? Kuch poochna hai yahan tak to pooch sakte ho. Fine. Now, let's put both the values in equation number 1. Right? Let's put both the values in equation number 1. Yes, Jatin. Haan bolo. Yes, Jatin.
I'm both blur.
Huh? What are you saying? Bolo.
I'm board thoda blur aa raha. Video bhi thodi pause.
Now it's okay?
It's yes, okay? Ma'am. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Sorry. Okay, so we put both the values in equation number 1 and find total energy. So we put kinetic energy half m r square cos square omega t plus potential energy here. Okay? Plus potential energy here. So, एक भी म्यूट कर दो हुआ नहीं है कि एक्चुअली चौक से भी तो हुआ एक लिख के वाइट हो जाती है. इज दैट क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स? बोर्ड इज प्रॉपर्ली विजिबल नाउ? इधर देखिए, इज इट विजिबल जतिन? Jatin, is the board clear now? Okay. Right. So we put this potential energy also here. Half m r square sine square omega t. Okay. So we put both the values here. We put both the values here. Now, let us take common half m r square cos square omega t plus sine square omega t. So this becomes identity, sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So we put it equal to 1. We get total energy in SHM half m r square omega square. So this is total energy in SG. So learn all the expressions of kinetic energy, potential energy, and total energy. So total energy, you can see all are constants. It is independent of y. It is independent of displacement, right? It is not having y in it. It contains r, where r is maximum amplitude, which is a constant. So maximum total energy remains maximum or constant. Kinetic energy was equal to half m r square omega square cos square omega t. Let's shorten it also. You know y is equal to r sine omega t. So sine omega t is equal to y by r here. Sine omega t kitna aega? Y by r here. Right. After that, cos square omega t will be 1 minus sine square omega t under the root. So this is how we can find cos omega t from here. Put this value of sine omega t here, 1 minus y square over r square. So we get from here, cos omega t is under the root r square minus y square over r square. This square root gets cancelled and we get under root r square minus y square over r square. So we have found cos omega t also. We had the value of sine omega t with us. Now we have found cos omega t also. Ye dekh lijiye, isme koi doubt hai to. How we have calculated cos omega t from sine omega t. Yes, any doubt to any student in these mathematical steps? Clear hai? So we will get two more expressions of kinetic energy and potential energy, right? So what was the formula of kinetic energy? It was half m r square omega square cos square omega t. Put the value of cos square omega t here. Half m r square omega square, that is r square minus y square. ठीक है, square करके अगर हम लिखें तो ये आ जाएगा. Square करके, that was cos omega t. If we put cos square omega t, तो under root गया over r square, right? R square gets cancelled and we get half m omega square r square minus y square. So learn, this is the formula of kinetic energy. And it depends upon y. It depends upon y, which is a variable, right? So that's why kinetic energy will go on changing. So that's why we find at mean position, kinetic energy is different. At extreme positions, kinetic energy is different. So it depends upon y. But we had seen that total energy is independent of y. So that will always remain constant. Now let's come to potential energy. In the same terms, we will derive an expression for potential energy also. Earlier it was in the form of sine omega t and cos omega t. Now let us derive in terms of the same parameters. So remember, we started with potential energy, half m r square omega square sine square omega t. Here it was sine square in place of cos square. So we have the value of sine omega t also with us, y over r. Put this value here. Put this value of sine omega t here. After squaring it, kya aa jayega? Dekhiye, this is half m r square omega square. और साइन क्या आ जाएगी? वाई स्क्वायर ओवर आर स्क्वायर. दिस आर स्क्वायर गेट कैंसल्ड. दिस आर स्क्वायर गेट्स कैंसल्ड और पोटेंशियल एनर्जी का फॉर्मूला आ गया आपके पास, हाफ एम ओमेगा स्क्वायर वाई स्क्वायर. सो अगेन यू कैन सी दैट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी आल्सो डिपेंड्स अपॉन वाई. पोटेंशियल एनर्जी आल्सो डिपेंड्स अपॉन डिस्प्लेसमेंट, व्हिच इज वेरिंग. तो ये भी चेंज होती है एट एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन मीन पोजीशन, बट वी हैड सीन दैट टोटल एनर्जी में वाई आया ही नहीं, तो दैट मीन्स इट विल ऑलवेज रिमेन द सेम. सो दिस इज एनर्जी इन SHN. This is energy in SHN. See that. Okay. Any doubt in this whole derivation? You can ask. If there is any doubt in the derivation, students, you can ask now. Puchna hai kisi ko kuch? Yes, students. Puchna hai kisi ko? कोई भी स्टेप क्लियर नहीं है तो पूछ सकते हैं. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्लॉट अ ग्राफ ऑफ ऑल द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ एनर्जी दैट मींस. ठीक है, अब काइनेटिक एनर्जी देखिए. लेट अस टेक सिंपल पेंडुलम एट मीन पोजीशन. एट मीन पोजीशन डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज जीरो, पुट वाई जीरो. सो व्हाट इज काइनेटिक एनर्जी एट द मीन पोजीशन? हाफ एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा स्क्वायर मैक्सिमम. इट इज इक्वल टू टोटल एनर्जी. मैक्सिमम हो गई, इसका मतलब एट मीन पोजीशन काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज मैक्सिमम. एट एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन वाई इज इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस आर. राइट साइड पे प्लस और लेफ्ट साइड पे माइनस आर होता है. सो पुट वाई इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस आर हियर. आर स्क्वायर माइनस आर स्क्वायर जीरो हो जाएगा. So kinetic energy would be zero here. Same way potential energy में mean position पे y zero होगा, potential energy zero, और extreme position पे y r होगा, potential energy would be equal to total energy which will be maximum. ठीक है, चलिए ग्राफ कल करते हैं इसका. यहां तक पढ़ के आइए.